Boku no Hero Academia, an anime that quickly rose to join the ranks as one of the most legendary shows of our time, with its incredible character design, awesome animation, and a rad story to boot. The three-hit combo of shows. And with such an extraordinary show comes some extraordinary cosplays in kind. Seriously, bnha cosplayers are killing it, dude. I haven't seen body paint this rad since I was a Homestuck cosplayer. Some of you guys even made yourselves invisible. Okay. Every single bnha cosplay is rad, including yours. Yes, you, dude. But wait, there is a massive cast in bnha, and the character you love enough to make a whole cosplay out of says a lot about you. Let me explain. These are all for fun. All your cosplays are valid. I love all of you very much. Okay, let's go. If you're a Deku cosplayer, you probably wear flower crowns and use uwu, unironically. You're really into Porter Robinson and probably watch Game Grumps. Oh, and you definitely always manage to find drama at conventions. You're definitely a Kenny too. Unquestionably. If you're a Bakugo cosplayer, you were really into Carcat. Who am I kidding? You're still really into Carcat. You're also either one of those weird alcoholic muscle dudes or a butch lesbian. Oh, and you probably liked Junkrat too. You also run an aesthetic blog and keep your anime tucked away in your Instagram. We've all seen your story. We know you have the Bakugo Nindoroid. You don't have to rub it in, man. If you're a Todoroki cosplayer, Zuko was your previous fave character because you really like fire dudes with fucked up faces. You probably really like pop punk and like to say you don't like anime, but everyone knows you do. Oh, and you're probably really into the Arizona iced tea aesthetic. You know what I mean. If you're an Ochako cosplayer, you're probably super into J fashion. You like cute things, Rilakkuma, Sanrio. But on the inside, you're definitely into hentai. You absolutely have an Ida bag of either Deku or Ochako. You also have an Instagram that's nothing but closet cosplay selfies, with the occasional picture from a con sprinkled in. More than likely, you watch a ton of beauty bloggers. If you're a Tsuyu cosplayer, you're probably on the quiet side. You tend to go to cons alone, and if you don't, you tend to wander away from your group. You probably also love Animal Crossing. I mean, you love Animal Crossing. Just as much as you love Slime Rancher, Stardew Valley, any game like that. But don't be fooled, Tsuyu cosplayers kill it in the rhythm game room. Oh, and Tsuyu cosplayers are really extra too, but in the best of ways. If you cosplay Mineta, what the fuck are you doing? If you cosplay Mina, you're a hardcore D&D player. Justin, Griffin, Travis, the McElroy brothers are your sole source of online content, and you wouldn't have it any other way. You probably also cosplay Taco the Wizard at some point in time, at least closetly. You definitely run a fashion blog, and you have absolutely tried to learn Japanese in the past, but you couldn't be fucked to learn hiragana. If you cosplay Jiro, you're punk till you die. Or some weird grungy mix? You're walking around to Arctic Monkeys, gorillas, with a little MCR and Fall Out Boy sprinkled in occasionally. You're probably one of those people who has taxidermy in their rooms, but in an artsy sort of way. And at one point, you were definitely into Homestuck way too much. But that's okay. No one's judging you that hard. If you cosplay Kirishima, you're definitely lanky as fuck. It's not even to mention the fact that Kirishima cosplayers always go, like, all out. I have never seen a Kirishima cosplay that did not look incredible. They always go so hard at the rave, too, dude. Kirishima cosplayers are just the best con buds. All around, hands down, no contest. They also always go to the 18 plus panels at cons. And yes, that is a call out. They're as into hentai as Uraraka cosplayers, but they're much more open about it. Also, you're unironically into Initial D. For some reason. If you cosplay Aizawa, you're the type of dude who's into anime dads. All your favorite characters are background characters, dude. The main characters are cool too. They're main for a reason. You've mastered the art of showing up late to everything. And you own a really old Android phone just because you can't be bothered to upgrade. You own a nice camera, but always say you left it somewhere. Oh, and your idea of a good time at a convention is sitting a lot. If you cosplay Ida, you are probably a true embodiment of the word softy. You're incredibly fun to be around in any situation. You're into Vocaloid, like really into Vocaloid, and you're proud of it. Ida cosplayers are the type of dudes to buy Starbucks for everybody in the group. Oh, and they probably actually run track in real life too. They're just all around great people. And last, but certainly not least, if you cosplay Toga, you run a blog dedicated to pastel gore. You are a closet furry and will never admit it to anyone. Vriska Circuit was, at one point in time, your lifeblood. You have a really adorable room that you're super proud of, and you probably play Minecraft religiously. Did I mention you're into swords? I didn't have to. Everyone already knew that. And there you have it. The wigs have been snatched. The cards are on the table. Once again, these were entirely for fun. All of you and all of your cosplays are so wonderful and so valid. That being said, are you a bnha cosplayer? How accurate were all those things I just said? Let me know in the comments down below. Beyond that, thank you so much for watching. I had a wonderful time writing this, producing this. This has been a video I've wanted to make for a super long time. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And above all else, be safe. Make good choices. Have a wonderful day. Peace out.